أعوذ بالله من الشيطان الرجيم. بسم الله الرحمن الرحيم.
لا أقسم بيوم القيامة.
I swear by the day of resurrection.
بسم الله الرحمن الرحيم. لا أقسم بهذا يوم القيامة. I swear by the day of resurrection. You think it is impossible? I swear by it. It is going to come.
ولا أقسم بالنفس اللوامة.
And I swear by the reproaching soul to the certainty of resurrection.
ولا أقسم بالنفس اللوامة. Nay, I swear by the self-reproaching soul within you, the conscience which bites you. When you do something wrong, there's something within you. You yourself say, my conscience is biting me. Don't you see? What is this conscience? This is a sign that you are responsible. You are accountable. And some reward will come to you. Some punishment will come to you. This is the proof of resurrection within you. وَفِي أَنفُسِكُمْ أَفَلَا تُبْصِرُونَ
أَيَحْسَبُ الْإِنسَانُ أَلَّن نَجْمَعَ عِظَامَهُ.
Does man think that we will not assemble his bones?
أَيَحْسَبُ الْإِنسَانُ أَلَّن نَجْمَعَ عِظَامَهُ. Does man think that we will not be able to gather his bones when he's dead and disintegrated?
بَلَى قَادِرِينَ عَلَىٰ أَن نُسَوِّيَ بَنَانَهُ.
Yes, we are able even to proportion his fingertips.
Bala, why not? قادرين على أن نسوي بنانه. We are fully capable of restoring his very fingertips.
بل يريد الإنسان ليفجر أمامه.
But man desires to continue in sin.
بل يريد الإنسان ليفجر أمامه. The real cause is that this man wants to continue evil. Go on sinning in this life in front of him.
يسأل أيان يوم القيامة.
He asks, when is the day of resurrection?
يسأل أيان يوم القيامة. He asks very haughtily, okay, when will this day of judgment come? Tell us if you are true.
فإذا برق البصر.
So when vision is dazzled.
فإذا برق البصر. But when the sight will be dazed.
وخسف القمر.
And the moon darkens.
وخسف القمر. And the moon will be eclipsed.
وجمع الشمس والقمر.
And the sun and the moon are joined.
وجمع الشمس والقمر. And the moon and the sun will be joined together. This moon will go into the sun.
يقول الإنسان يومئذ أين المفر.
Man will say on that day, where is the place of escape?
يقول الإنسان يومئذ أين المفر. That day this man will say, is there any place to run? Is there any place to hide?
كَلَّا لَا وَزَرْ.
No, there is no refuge.
كَلَّا لَا وَزَرْ. And it will be told, no, there's no place of refuge.
إِلَى رَبِّكَ يَوْمَئِذٍ الْمُسْتَقَرْ.
To your Lord, that day is the place of permanence.
إِلَى رَبِّكَ يَوْمَئِذٍ الْمُسْتَقَرْ. There's only one place, and that is with your Lord. You have to go to Him. You have to stand before Him.
يُنَبَّأُ الْإِنسَانُ يَوْمَئِذٍ بِمَا قَدَّمَ وَأَخَّرُ.
Man will be informed that day of what he sent ahead and kept back.
يُنَبَّأُ الْإِنسَانُ يَوْمَئِذٍ بِمَا قَدَّمَ وَأَخَّرُ. And every human being will be told on that day what he sent before coming to that and what he left behind. These are the two aspects of human deeds. We are doing something good, bad, and we are sending it. It's going on continuously and being recorded over there till our death. But when we depart from here, we leave behind something, either good or bad. If you started some good institution, it is working after you. After you have gone, it is working, benefiting people. You will get the credits. You will go on getting the credit. So this is akhar. Qaddama wa akhara. What he sent before and what he left behind.
بل الإنسان على نفسه بصيرة.
Rather, man against himself will be a witness.
بل الإنسان على نفسه بصيرة. But actually, no man will need to be told what he has done. He himself knows where he stands. Every insan is an evidence against himself. He knows himself.
وَلَوْ أَلْقَى مَعَاذِيرَهُ
Even if he presents his excuses.
وَلَوْ أَلْقَى مَعَاذِيرَهُ Even though he is to put up his excuses and explanations and rationalization, but in the heart of his heart, he something says, you are telling a lie. You have quietened these people by giving explanations and rationalizing, I did this because of this, and that was the reason, not this was the intention. Okay, people are quietened. But still, something in you says, you are telling a lie. And this is it. بَلِ الْإِنسَانُ عَلَىٰ نَفْسِهِ بَصِيرَةٌ وَلَوْ أَلْقَى مَعَاذِيرَهُ
لا تحرك به لسانك لتعجل به.
Move not your tongue with it, O Muhammad, to hasten with recitation of the Quran.
لا تحرك به لسانك لتعجل به. Don't move your tongue hastily to remember this Quran.
إن علينا جمعه وقرآنه.
Indeed, upon us is its collection in your heart. And to make possible its recitation.
إِنَّ عَلَيْنَا جَمْعَهُ وَقُرْآنَهُ We take responsibility. That number one, you will not forget it. We shall gather it in your heart or in your mind. And Qur'ana, the sequence of recitation, that is also upon us. We will tell you where to place this surah. A surah is being revealed now, where it should be placed. Among the surahs that have already been revealed. And
إِذَا قَرَأْنَاهُ فَاتَّبِعْ قُرْآنَهُ
So when we have recited it through Gabriel, then follow its recitation.
فَإِذَا قَرَأْنَاهُ فَاتَّبِعْ قُرْآنَهُ And when we fix this sequence of qiraat and recitation, then you have to follow the same sequence of qiraat. So there is the ahadith, you know, which tell that the Prophet ﷺ used to have a daura, a round of Qur'an, during this month of Ramadan, with Hazrat Jibreel alayhi salatu wasalam. He used to recite, and Jibreel used to listen. And in that way, you know, the sequence was being fixed. And in the last Ramadan of the life of the Prophet ﷺ, it was repeated twice. So the compilation was completed within the lifetime of the Prophet ﷺ. Although in the form of a book, it was not present. It was compiled in the form of a book during the caliphate of Hazrat Abu Bakr radiallahu ta'ala. But Quran had been compiled, the sequence had been fixed, and so many huffaz were there who had memorized the whole of Quran according to this sequence which we have today in Quran. And this is the sequence of Quran in the Lauh-e-Mahfuz, in the Kitab-e-Maknoon. This is there with the Lord, Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala. So now we proceed. Because there was one scene, you know, which was shown. What will happen on the Day of Judgment?
ثُمَّ إِنَّ عَلَيْنَا بَيَانَهُ
Then upon us is its clarification to you.
ثُمَّ إِنَّ عَلَيْنَا بَيَانَهُ Then it's also upon us, our duty, to explain it. This explanation came in two ways, either in Quran itself. Something was revealed and then there were questions from the companions of the Prophet, then Allah sent another ayah to explain that. Yastaftunak. Twice in Surah An-Nisa we have Yastaftunak. These people are asking you about that. So Allah makes it more clear. So this ayat. Either Quran or the Hadith of the Prophet Sallallahu Alaihi Wasallam. Kitabun anzalnahu ilayka mubarakan. The other ayah. لِتُبَيَّنَ لِلنَّاسِ مَا نُزِّلَ إِلَيْهِمْ إِنَّا نَزَّلْنَا عَلَيْكَ الزِّكْرَ لِتُبَيَّنَ لِلنَّاسِ مَا نُزِّلَ إِلَيْهِمْ. We have sent this zikr for the humanity, for mankind, but on you, so that you explain it to the people.
كَلَّا بَلْ تُحِبُّونَ الْعَاجِلَةِ.
No, but you love the immediate.
كَلَّا بَلْ تُحِبُّونَ الْعَاجِلَةِ. Nay, O people, O mankind, your real disease is that you love this life, which is ajila, which is present. The gain of this life, you feel palpable. The loss, palpable, you feel. You are only thinking about this life. You love this life.
وَتَذَرُونَ الْآخِرَةِ.
And leave the hereafter.
وَتَذَرُونَ الْآخِرَةِ. And you have given away the hereafter. You never think about the hereafter.
وُجُوهٌ يَوْمَئِذٍ نَاضِرَةٌ.
Some faces that day will be radiant.
وُجُوهٌ يَوْمَئِذٍ نَاضِرَةٌ. When the whole mankind will be standing before Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala, waiting for the judgment. Now on the faces of the people, the judgment would be there written on their faces. Just as we have, you know, during the high school days, there used to be declared, you know, result is going to be declared on 1st of March. And when the students were there, so everybody could see on the face who is going to fail and who is going to pass. So actually, before the announcement of the judgment of Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala, the people will know what is going to happen to us. Therefore, some of the faces will be very fresh, radiant, and they will be looking towards Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala. And some of the faces will be gloomy, and they will be fearing that now the treatment which will break their bone, backbone, is going to be done to them. Now the scene is of the death. That is the bigger qiyamah, and this is the smaller qiyamah of every person, individual person. When you die, as the Prophet has said, مَمْ مَاتَ فَقَدْ قَامَتْ قِيَامَتُهُ. Who dies, his qiyamah has come. Because now he cannot do anything. He cannot earn, you know, any good deeds. So whatever he could earn, he had earned already. As if his qiyamah has come. So it's seen from that qiyamah, when death comes.
إِلَىٰ رَبِّهَا نَاظِرَةٌ.
Looking at their Lord.
إِلَىٰ رَبِّهَا نَاظِرَةٌ. And they'll be looking towards their Lord. May Allah include us among them.
وَوْجُوهٌ يَوْمَئِذٍ بَاسِرَةٌ.
And some faces that day will be contorted.
وَوْجُوهٌ يَوْمَئِذٍ بَاسِرَةٌ. And many faces on that day will be gloomy.
تَظُنُّ أَن يُفْعَلَ بِهَا فَاقِرَةٌ.
Expecting that there will be done to them something backbreaking.
تَظُنُّ أَن يُفْعَلَ بِهَا فَاقِرَةٌ. And they will be thinking that now some back-breaking treatment will be done to them.
No, when the soul has reached the collarbones.
Nay, when the departing soul reaches the collarbone, you know, when it is all going out and reaches here.
من راق.
And it is said, who will cure him?
وَقِيلَ مَنْ رَاق. And it is said, is there any soothsayer? Now the doctors have given, you know, they have said he's hopeless. We can't do anything. You can take your patient to your home. But is there any soothsayer, some sorcerer, someone who can save his life?
وَظَنَّ أَنَّهُ الْفِرَاقُ.
And the dying one is certain that it is the time of separation.
وَظَنَّ أَنَّهُ الْفِرَاقُ. And now that person himself has come to believe that now this is the departure. I have to leave this world, I'm going.
وَالْتَفَّتِ السَّاقُ بِالسَّاقُ.
And the leg is wound about the leg.
وَالْتَفَّتِ السَّاقُ بِالسَّاقُ. In that, you know, the legs will come together and twist round each other. This is, you know, alam naza. When, you know, this life is being taken out, the soul is being taken out. It's a very hard time on human beings if you have seen people dying, you know. So the legs will be twisting around each other.
إِلَىٰ رَبِّكَ يَوْمَئِذٍ الْمَسَاقُ.
To your Lord that day will be the procession.
إِلَىٰ رَبِّكَ يَوْمَئِذٍ الْمَسَاقُ. So on that day, you will be driven towards your Lord, and there is no other place to run away and to have any refuge.
فَلَا صَدَّقَ وَلَا صَلَّى.
And the disbeliever had not believed, nor had he prayed.
فَلَا صَدَّقَ وَلَا صَلَّى. But he neither affirmed nor prayed. This is the condition of the chiefs of Quraysh. They listen to Muhammad sallallahu alaihi wasallam, but they didn't accept. فَلَا صَدَّقَ. Neither they accepted that whatever you are saying is true and good. وَلَا صَلَّى. Nor were they ready to pray to Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala. On the contrary,
وَلَكِن كَذَّبَ وَتَوَلَّى.
But instead, he denied and turned away.
وَلَكِن كَذَّبَ وَتَوَلَّى. But they belied and turned away.
ثُمَّ ذَهَبَ إِلَىٰ أَهْلِهِ يَتَمَطَّى.
And then he went to his people, swaggering in pride.
ثُمَّ ذَهَبَ إِلَىٰ أَهْلِهِ يَتَمَطَّى. And then he went to his family arrogantly.
أَوْلَىٰ لَكَ فَأَوْلَىٰ.
Woe to you and woe.
أَوْلَىٰ لَكَ فَأَوْلَىٰ. Woe to thee and woe to thee.
ثُمَّ أَوْلَىٰ لَكَ فَأَوْلَىٰ.
Then woe to you and woe.
ثُمَّ أَوْلَىٰ لَكَ فَأَوْلَىٰ. Again woe to thee, O man, woe.
أَيَحْسَبُ الْإِنسَانُ أَن يُتْرَكَ سُدَىٰ.
Does man think that he will be left neglected?
أَيَحْسَبُ الْإِنسَانُ أَن يُتْرَكَ سُدَىٰ. Does man think that he is to be left wandering aimlessly, unrewarded? He will be left alone. No reward, no punishment.
أَلَمْ يَكُ نُطْفَةً مِّن مَّنِيٍّ يُمْنَى.
Had he not been a sperm from semen emitted?
أَلَمْ يَكُ نُطْفَةً مِّن مَّنِيٍّ يُمْنَى. Was it not a sperm drop which was emitted?
ثُمَّ كَانَ عَلَقَةً فَخَلَقَ فَسَوَّى.
Then he was a clinging clot, and Allah created his form and proportioned him.
ثُمَّ كَانَ عَلَقَةً. Then he was a clot of blood, according to the old translations. But what I have come to understand, a leech-like structure hanging from the wall of the womb of the mother. عَلَقَ. مُعَلَّقَ. فَخَلَقَ فَسَوَّى. Then Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala created it and fashioned it and gave it the figure.
جَعَلَ مِنْهُ الزَّوْجَيْنِ الذَّكَرَ وَالْأُنْثَى.
And made of him two mates, the male and the female.
فَجَعَلَ مِنْهُ الزَّوْجَيْنِ الذَّكَرَ وَالْأُنْثَى. And then he made of him two kinds, the male and the female, from the same sperm drop. Allah is making one a male child, other a female child. The whole system of body different, psychologically different, everything different.
أَلَيْسَ ذَٰلِكَ بِقَادِرٍ عَلَىٰ أَن يُحْيِيَ الْمَوْتَىٰ.
Is not that creator able to give life to the dead?
أَلَيْسَ ذَلِكَ بِقَادِرٍ عَلَىٰ يُحْيَ الْمَوْتَىٰ Is not that Allah able to bring dead to life? If you could create you out of that sperm drop, can that Allah not bring you back to life after your death? And here we must say, بَلَىٰ يَا رَبَّ الْعَالَمِينَ وَنَحْنُ عَلَىٰ ذَلِكَ مِنَ الشَّاهِدِينَ Why not, O our Lord? And we testify to it that actually this will happen.